What's up guys? In this tutorial, I will show you how to fix the network credentials error you are getting on your Windows PC. This should be quite an easy tutorial. For more information, click on the first link in the description below. There are several ways to fix the network credentials error on your Windows PC. First, open up your Start menu and search for Local Security Policy. In the Local Security Policy window, expand Local Policies, and then select Security Options. Next, locate the Accounts policy. Limit local accounts' use of blank passwords to console login only. Double-click to open it, and then disable this account policy before proceeding to click OK. If this doesn't help, then you will have to make use of your Windows Services Manager. Search for services.msc in your Start menu and open it up. On this window, click anywhere inside the panel to activate it. Use the C key to instantly pinpoint services starting with the letter C and look out for the Credential Manager service. Double-click the service to access its properties. Here, set the startup type to disabled and stop the service from running. Hit Apply and click OK before closing the services window. Restart your device and the network credentials error will be fixed for most users. If the problem persists, open up your control panel by searching for it in your Start menu search. In the search bar located at the upper right corner of your screen, search for Credential Manager. Open it and remove all the web and Windows credentials, if any are listed. With that done, your network credentials error will be fixed. If all else fails, then we need to turn off password-protected sharing in the Control Panel's Advanced Sharing settings. In your Control Panel, navigate to Network and Internet, Network and Sharing Center. Select Change Advanced Sharing Settings on the top left of this window. From here, expand the All Networks tab and proceed to disable the password-protected sharing option. This will fix the network credentials error you are getting on your Windows PC. These steps and more information will be available in my extensive guide linked in the description below. I hope this helped you out. Leave a comment if you have any questions and see you in the next one.